on the show tonight, the star of An Officer and a Gentleman, where a plain Jane who's given up on romance is swept off her feet by a hunky man in uniform. I mean, seriously, as if that could happen. Let's start the show! Must remember to send flowers. Now, welcome all. What an exciting couch tonight. Hollywood legend Richard Gere is on the show. I know. Star of Hannah, Atonement and the Lovely Bones, Saoirse Ronan is on the show. Yes, she is. It's a welcome back for Con Air, and in the line of fire star, John Malkovich is here, ladies and gentlemen. That's not all. Later on, we're going to be having music from the fantastic Taylor Swift, everybody. I know! I know! Over there! On this show! Oh! Kel lined up. French for what a lineup. So, absolutely thrilled to welcome Richard Gere back. Well, not back, just on the show. Famous, of course, for the iconic An Officer and a Gentleman. Oh, there. Yeah. Oh, I tell you, a man in uniform, when is that not sexy? Huh? They do Spanx for men now. Yeah, they do. Richard has starred in many great films, Pretty Woman, American Gigolo, and, of course, the Arthurian drama First Night. Yeah, there he is on his trusty horse, Ready Meal. Yeah. Oh, come on, it's already wrapped in foil. It's oven ready. Hey, a big welcome to my Irish compatriot, Saoirse Ronan. Yeah, lovely. Oh, what a lovely actress. As a 15-year-old, she starred in Hannah. Oh, such a good movie. Look at her there. Oh, they grow up so fast, don't they? One minute they're watching Peppa Pig, the next they're blowing someone's brains out. Now, of course, she was Oscar-nominated for her role in Atonement. Yeah, that's her as the young Bryony Tallis. In the film, you also see her character as an old woman. There she is, yes. It does make you think, I wonder what I'll look like when I'm really old. Hey, let's get some guests on! Later, we'll have music and chat from Taylor Swift! But first, time for a dangerous liaison, it's John Malkovich!
Oh, I can hear. I shake my hand here. And on you go, sir.
John Malkovich! She's got lovely bones! It's Saoirse Ronan! Oh!
Hello, lovely lady.
Hi. Oh.
Sit yourself down. It's all the Saoirse.
And we're top gear tonight. It is Mr. Richard Gere!
Okay.
Is it coming back? Is it coming?
killed about 10 minutes there, right?
I know, it's great. It's great. Sit yourself down.
Oh, dear. Join me next week when my guests include... I've got just 45 minutes of laughing
What a weird show.
Actors don't like that, do they?
No, they hate
don't
it.
Want applause.
You didn't get into the business for that. So, welcome all to the couch. Now, Saoirse Ronan, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's how you say it. Because people do get it wrong a lot.
Saoirse, yeah, like Saoirse. Inertia.
Inertia.
It's the Saoirse. Best way to... I have to introduce myself that way now. Saoirse, like inertia. Because people don't get it otherwise. They butcher my name.
But in Ireland, people say it different ways. So, like, isn't there a Saoirse?
Yeah, I don't think I actually pronounce my name the correct way. I say Saoirse, but a lot of people in Ireland say, no, it's actually Saoirse. I think you're saying that wrong. So I don't know. I'm going to say Saoirse.
John, are you hearing the subtle difference between Saoirse and Saoirse?
I am. I'm just wondering what she says when they tell her she says her name wrong.
Actually, not the only unusual name on the couch, because, Richard, on your middle name is... unexpected, I would have thought.
Something's going to happen now, I know.
No! Nothing bad happened. No, but your middle name's Tiffany.
It's Tiffany. It is Tiffany.
What's so funny about that?
It's not the Tiffany's, by the way. No, but it comes through... This was my mother's side. That's her maiden name is Tiffany. And it came through Belgium somehow.
Oh, okay. I'm guessing you kept that quiet in school, I imagine.
You want to know how ridiculous I am? I almost used it as my stage name.
No.
Richard Tiffany Dash Gear.
It
was a good choice not to do that, wasn't it?
Did an agent just go, no?
No, no,
that's
no.
That's a very bad idea.
No, no, no.
Now, Oscar weekend, and Richard, you're on presenting duties. You're being reunited with the cast of Chicago.
Yes, that's true.
Are you singing?
No, we're just presenting.
Okay. Now, I think that's very nice of you, because in Chicago you were famously snubbed by...
Yeah, thank you so much for bringing that up.
Well, it annoyed me at the time, and it still annoys me. Yeah. Well, no, because every other in the cast got nominated.
It's true. It's
true. You sitting by the phone thinking, surely it'll... Surely I...
You want to know the truth? I'll tell you the story. We were opening the movie in Paris, and we're all in the same hotel. Can't remember what hotel it was, but one room right next to each other. And the... I don't know what time it would have been, but in L.A. they were making the announcements. And all the doors were open because we were going off to do interviews and stuff. And so we could hear it down the hallway. So this one gets nominated, because next one, that one gets nominated, that one gets nominated. And I did feel a little kind of... And it went right past me. That one got nominated, the next one got nominated, the movie got nominated, photography got nominated, the music got nominated.
But you're probably talked about the most because you didn't get nominated, so...
Oh, look at that. Every cloud. Every cloud. And then, but feel... But Saoirse, here you were, 13 years old, nominated for an Oscar, which is an amazing thing, to be 13 nominated for an Oscar. You pop on your frock, off you go. Now, it's...
Yeah, it's a while ago.
But it seems cruel to do that to a 13-year-old girl and then what? Just not give you the prize.
And not give it to me, I know.
Did you have a big tantrum when you're going, hey, you've had an Oscar!
I threw off my Jimmy Choos and I threw them at John Stewart. No, well, like, I mean, you know, I was 13 at the time, so it was... And actually, it was the first ever award ceremony I ever went to.
So in at the top.
I aimed quite high. But it, I mean, it was lovely. And I knew I wasn't going to win anyway. Tilda Swinton won in the end, and you know, which was the way it should have been because she's brilliant. So.
Yeah, she's all right.
She's good as the White Witch.
And John, you've been nominated twice. Did you go both times? Do you like it?
I missed the second one, Graham. The first one I went. All I really remember of it, it was at the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion then, which has a kind of enormous foyer. It was just about 8 or 10 people with massive kind of snow shovels following the elephants from passage to India who were doing their thing in the foyer. While waiting to go on stage, the elephants. And that's really all I remember.
That's show
so
business.
So this is Hollywood. yeah.
But now, going back to awards, congratulations to you, Richard. Golden Globe Best Actor nomination for Arbitrage.
Thank you.
Arbitrage, new movie, out March the 1st. And the movie, I've seen it, it's an excellent film.
Thanks.
And the story, it's not based on the Bernie Madoff Ponzi scheme. But is it inspired by that?
No. It's that world, for sure. But,
yeah.
But it's not Bernie. But, you know, when we started to make the film, he was kind of the poster boy for everything wrong with the financial world. But this character I'm playing is not a sociopath like John would have played, I'm sure.
Not only would I have played it, I invested with him.
No, did you really?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, no. Yeah. But did you invest early, so you made lots of money?
Or yeah, you were the one of the guys that actually made money, weren't you?
No.
But the odd thing is that your character, I mean, he would appear to be a villain, but he's rather sympathetic and...
Well, he's not one of those guys. He certainly is a very powerful... He's got the money, he's got the plane, he's got the car, he's got everything is in place. And we kind of deconstruct him in the process of the movie. He's made some very bad financial bets, and now he's got to fix it. And then, as you saw the movie, some other things happen, which also...
Yes.
Put enormous pressure on the man. And there's a ticking clock, so he's got to fix everything quickly. And in the process, we see what's inside this guy. My job in this was to make him a human being and not a villain with a capital V. We're very complex, all of us. I never met a simple person in my life.
Well, there are some. Right, we've got a clip, Richard. We've got a clip. This is a scene with you and your daughter. She's discovered at this point what you've been doing.
It's in the park.
Okay. Yeah. Here we go.
Thanks to you, we may all be arrested.
No one's getting arrested. That's why I borrowed the money from Jeffrey. Plugged the hole. They see that the books are fine. Transfer the company. I pay back Jeffrey with interest. I make all of our investors whole, and what's left we keep.
At least we get to keep the house.
Everybody wins.
Yes.
If we sell the company.
It'll sell.
If I lie for you.
You don't have to lie. You didn't know about it. That's why I didn't tell you.
I'm the chief investment officer of this company. What do you think they're going to say at the deposition? She didn't know. They'll take away my brokerage license, failure to supervise you, my name in every paper and blog while I visit
your attorney. What do you want me to do? Did you want me to let our investors go bankrupt? Is that what you wanted? You wanted people to get really hurt.
That gives you the audacity to think that you can make other people.
No, because it's my job.
Job?
Yes.
It's illegal. It's illegal. And I am your partner.
You are not my partner. You work for me. That's right. You work for me. Everybody works for me.
Ooh. You are so good in this film. It's such a good movie. Really, really
Thanks.
Good. And I read in this one interview, you were talking about how this film sort of is almost like a riposte to how money is seen in Pretty Woman.
I never said that.
Oh, did you not say that? Was that a reviewer?
No, everyone tries to get me to say that.
Oh, sorry. I guess, is it because at the time of Pretty Woman, you in interviews, you were talking about how you were nervous of how it did kind of say, if you've got money, it's all fine?
I don't know what you're talking about.
In reading old interviews, in preparing, yes, I prepare. Talking about Pretty Woman at the time, I remember you saying that you were nervous of how it kind of basically said, if you've got the cash, it's kind of a panacea. No.
Such a lie.
I honestly don't know
Can
what
I borrow
you're talking
a pen?
About.
Like a fictitious biog has been passed to me.
I honestly don't know where this is coming from.
I don't know either.
I keep trying.
Shall I keep going?
Yes.
Well, no. I think what I do know, and this is true, because of the way films came out in Ireland, they take ages to come out. In one weekend, I remember I went to see American Gigolo and An Officer and a Gentleman.
Wow.
In one weekend. And honestly, at the end of it, I knew your body better than my own. This was Ireland. Oh my God.
I wish I still had that body.
It's in there. Now, in American Gigolo, is it true that the suits were actually, they were made for John Travolta? Is that true? No.
No, actually, it's not true. No, no, what happened?
Were you in An Officer and a Gentleman?
Yes.
Somewhere.
Good, you can stop now. You've got a yes.
Phew, we're back on track. We're back on track. But you have been, in all these iconic films. And so you are famous, presumably all over the world. Is it Borneo? This is another one of this. No, I have never been to Borneo. I never intend to go to Borneo. I didn't know that country existed.
I never even heard of Borneo.
Did you go to Borneo?
This is absolutely true, right?
Thank God for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, Graham Norton, ladies and gentlemen. Stand up. Stand up. Take a bow. Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. It's not normally like this. It's not normally like this. But someone will be fired.
Yeah. They're hiding back there.
No, they're gone.
Yeah.
But you did go to Borneo.
Well, I did. This is actually. Do you want the long story or the short story? How much time do we have?
Oh, all the time in the world. Well, yeah. We just cut through an awful lot of questions there. So, we're nearing the end now.
Should I get the audience again?
Do that later. Do that later.
All right. So I'm in Borneo, and I found a flight that got me to. I think it's called Samarinda. Was the capital of Indonesian Borneo, and I arranged with a missionary pilot to take me all the way into the center, way up in the jungle. And so we went up there, and it was just before the monsoon. Which, if monsoon, man, I could stretch this story out. I thought, man, this is good. I just remember this could go forever. This is a dinner story. Can we order dinner for everybody here? Because I haven't told this story fully in about 5 years. I'm willing to do it.
Let's fire go. Ahead.
Let's go.
Okay, pizza for everybody. Who's ordering? So we flew into this very short strip, and it was a one-prop plane. It was me and my Brazilian girlfriend, and it literally slammed right down. We had, 100 feet for this to happen, and it was one of the few pilots who could do it. Got off there. And it was along a river, and this tribe, I'm trying to remember the tribe, the Arawaks, not the Arawaks. Anyway, it was a tribe that bones through here, bones with the flesh of the ears was hanging down with bones in it, naked, and markings all over, and the whole thing, a dugout canoe. And so the missionary pilot has to take off, so we're left there, get in the canoe, go up river, we come to this longhouse, and it's all hand gestures and whatever. And we start to walk up to the longhouse, and the whole tribe comes out, and they start going, "Officer Gentleman! Officer Gentleman!" True story.
It takes the shine off.
When the pizza comes, I'll tell you how we got out of there.
John, it seems that you kind of shun the limelight, and I sort of get it, because was it... You found a woman in your garden once. Is that right?
Yeah. yes, a very big woman. was dressed maybe a little too provocatively. And I was at our house in France, and I was talking to my producing partners out in Los Angeles, and I turned around, and there was this kind of, like a kind of Michelin woman, and she explained that she had come there because she wanted to be my assistant, and I said I didn't think that was a good idea, and then she said she also wanted me to read her screenplay. And I looked at the title of it, which had kind of looked like it had been maybe scratched in with a bloody nail, or the claw of a hammer. And it was in French, elle tue, which means she kills. And I thought, I said, that seems very interesting. What's it about? And she explained that it was about an out-of-work woman who kills a well-known actor.
Now, Saoirse, here's the weird thing about Saoirse, is because every time we see you in a movie, you've grown up, so you look incredibly different every time we see you. So do you get recognised that much?
I don't really, to be honest. I do in Ireland. I think, but just
because... probably just knew you anyway. It's a small country.
Yeah, you know, we're all Canadians at home. Graham and I are cousins.
Yeah.
But I mean, outside of Ireland, not so much. Every now and again, I mean, I'll get people who will come up to me abroad and they'll ask me to sign an autograph with my face on it. And I'm signing it and they're like, so what films are you in? What have you been in? Did you not?
What have you done?
Why have you printed out my face? If you don't know who I am. So I've gotten that quite a bit. But nobody knows who I am.
Oh, stop it.
I don't mind.
Don't encourage her. Well, no, listen, it's going to change because you're in this new movie, The Host, which is the new movie from the writer of the Twilight series.
Yeah, Stephanie Meyer, so...
So, I mean, this is going to be huge.
It might be, yeah. I mean, there's certainly a lot of buzz around it, which has been...
And do they kind of sit you down and talk to you about what's going to happen when this movie hits? I mean, have you met the Twilight kids and talked to them about what happened?
I haven't, no. I went to the last premiere in LA. But no, I didn't get to talk to them. I didn't get to meet any of them because I think they had to fly off somewhere else. But
they were just rude and unfriendly. I think that's what you're saying.
I didn't want to meet them then.
Yeah, they were a bit up themselves. Good luck, Twilight cast.
You know,
they're not in The Host.
Anyway, they're finished.
Yeah, they're over.
You know, we're the new guys.
Yeah, yeah.
But
Twilight,
no,
the sun has set.
You're gone.
Yeah, it's night now.
But no, I didn't get to meet them, but you know. That's all right.
Yeah. But in this movie, you play two people, but they're both... They share your body.
Yeah. So, basically, it's about our planet being taken over by aliens.
Keep going.
Pretty much. I'm gonna...
Keep going.
It's good, honestly.
It's a movie.
It's a movie. It's not real. But, yeah, they're taken over by these sort of foreign bodies called souls, and their goal is to... perfect any planet that they inhabit. So when they come to Earth, what they do is they'll capture a human and they put a soul inside of them and the soul sort of takes over the human body. So I sort of played the host of the body and the soul. And it was great. Like, you know, there were loads of scenes where I just got to talk to myself the whole time. I didn't need to deal with anyone else, you know. So it was great.
Hey, The Host opens here on the 29th of March. And yeah. We've got a kind of a taster clip of your character and the movie.
Barely a bone not broken or organ ruptured.
This one wants to live.
When we occupy this host, her memories will lead us to the resistance.
Her name is Melanie Strider. She was born in Louisiana. Her family escaped the initial waves of colonization.
What is happening? Is she resisting? It's important you stay in control of this host.
Oh my God. It's driving.
Pretty intense.
Very intense.
Yeah. Lots of chrome.
And with the action sequences in this, are you action ready after all the training you did for Hannah?
Yeah, I don't have that much action to do in The Host. Everyone thinks I do, but I don't. I mean, I really like doing that kind of stuff. I like training for films beforehand, physically, and, you know...
But Hannah sounded really hard because she was fighting Eric Bana.
Yeah,
like, he's
huge.
He's a big guy.
Yeah. Well, I had been training for a couple of months before that and really got into the martial arts. So we started to do our choreography every day and he was kind of holding back and he was like, no, we'll take it easy, you know. And I really went for it. And according to him, I was surprisingly strong. So I did actually punch him a few times in the face. Which he was a bit shocked by.
Yes.
But yeah, it happened a few times, and I think I probably took advantage of it because I knew he was going to hold back, and I wasn't going to.
Instinct took over. And
yeah, I knew.
Oh, sorry.
But he said you were very good at the punching.
Yeah, apart from the times that I hit him in the face. Yeah.
Can you show us a fake punch?
A fake punch.
A fake punch.
An air movie punch.
Yes.
What kind of a punch, though?
Well, I don't know. Like a. If you punch my face,
yeah.
Why am I even suggesting this?
Yeah.
If I sound like my back,
shall I do like a cross or something?
Do a cross.
Okay, well you need to kind of get into your stance. So what are you doing? You look really scared. So just kind of
punch Derek Banner.
Bend your knees a little bit. Okay. And are you ready?
Yeah, I'm not doing anything.
No, but you need to react to it because you will get punched then.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay,
okay.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, you did. I'm gonna go here.
Oh!
I'm gonna hit my back then.
Yes,
I do.
Yes,
I do. That's all. Very good. Now, talking of action. And I'm hesitant to ask Richard a question because it's probably not true.
It's not true.
It's a load of rubbish. But in Officer Gentleman, it looked like you did all that.
Pick up Deborah Winger.
Yeah, he picked up Deborah Winger. He definitely did that. All that, all the press ups, the sit ups, all that. Did you really do all that?
Well, John knows. You do it the first take, right? You do 100 push ups the first take. Second one, you do 50. And then on the third or fourth take, you start at 90. And you go 90, 91.
90. Fourth take, you call your agent.
Yeah.
Talking of action, now, John, you've just finished filming Red 2, the sequel to The Reds, where you're all retired. Sorry. It does look like there was a fire and you had to grab just the first thing.
Yeah.
Is that a plot point?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Don't spoil it. But because you're all retired, does that kind of change the stunts or the action sequences that they write for you?
Yeah, there's a limit to what a lot of us can achieve stunt-wise. Like, if we can walk to the car... We feel okay. We're like, yeah, we really nailed it. We still shoot well.
Yes.
And Mary Louise and I had a fantastic scene where there's a car chase and the car Mary Louise is driving keeps being hit and therefore spinning around in circles. And at the end of the sequence, we were able to vomit at the window in tandem. And for us, that's a stunt. That kind of classifies, you get hazard pay.
That makes me want to see the film, just that one scene.
I hope it'll be funny.
Now, the thing is, on screen, you seem like a sort of a very intense actor, but actually you wear it quite lightly, I think. Was it Places of the Heart when you were playing a blind man and the director sort of expected you to do a lot of research?
Yeah, they asked me to go really every day to the Lighthouse for the Blind in Dallas, and I went once and talked to a couple of people, but all the other days I was looking for a used car, a Studebaker, and then when Robert Benton then said to me one day, you know, we're gonna shoot the scene where this character I played, it was called Mr. Will, where Mr. Will reads Braille. And I said, okay. And then my then wife, who happened to be in the room, said, I bet he doesn't even know how to read Braille. And they said, but of course he knows. He's been going to the lighthouse for the blind every day. And my then wife said, I bet he hasn't even gone once. Or he maybe went once for 5 minutes. And then they said, that's not true, is it? And I said, yeah, it's absolutely true. And they said, but you were going every day. And I said, but not to the lighthouse for the blind. I was going to look for a used car. And then they said, but you do know how to read Braille, don't you? No, of course not. I mean, well, what are we going to do? I don't know. Call someone who knows how to read Braille and then just tell me. I'm supposed to fly a jet plane in red. First of all, you don't want me to fly a jet plane. And I don't have time to learn how to do it. And it's dangerous for the passenger.
John also is lying, because he might have done that once, but he's also the kind of actor that learns how to do stuff. That's for sure.
Some I do, but it kind of depends.
If it's a skill you want to learn.
No, it doesn't even depend on that. It depends on if it's important for what's going to be seen in a frame. But then, of course, you have to learn to do all kinds of stuff. But if it doesn't really matter, I don't see it. Like fly a jet. Drive a car.
But what you did for Looking for Mr. Goodbar, that sounded quite extreme.
What did I do? Which was...
The character...
I don't know.
The character had lost everything. I'm betting this is true. This sounds true. Where you lost everything and you had about $1,000 in your bank account.
Oh, right. Actually, this is true.
Thank you very much.
This is 40 years ago we're talking about this stuff. And you're going way back.
I wouldn't know this crap either, but I happen to read it.
Yeah, so I didn't have any money anyhow. I might have had $1,200 to my name at that point, and it was a character who had lost everything. He was a gambler and everything. So I went to Las Vegas and played blackjack and lost everything. So at least I knew what it was like to have lost everything. I did not have a penny to my name.
What would have happened if you'd won?
I would have kept playing till I lost. And that definitely would happen eventually.
Yes, that's how that works.
But how did you get home?
That's another story, and I can't really tell that.
You're stacking it up. Listen, it's time for music. So this singer has won multiple Grammy Awards, sold millions of records, and is one of the biggest singing stars in the world right now. Performing her new single, I Knew You Were Trouble, it is Taylor Swift!
Long gone when it's next to me or her or anyone or anything.
Richard's been up and dancing. He's laughing. Oh. Can you sit down again? Or no?
No.
No.
No. Okay. No.
No. You're right.
No,
yeah.
I'm fine.
Taylor Swift, congratulations. That single's out now. Off the album, which is out now.
Yeah.
Which contains, with interest, 16 brand new songs. I noticed.
Oh, it says on the sticker.
It says right there. I'm no fool. congratulations to you on the Brits this week.
Oh yeah, that was fun.
Yeah. Great performance.
Thank you.
No, really. Didn't you? Did you watch it? Did you watch it? Really good. She put on a show. She put on a show. Look, Lucia, she's in that dress. Do you
dress.
See?
Wow.
We won't mention her dandruff. And and then, in a coup de théâtre, that went into this.
Tear what, away.
Yeah.
Two outfits on top of each other.
No, but that's quite hard to put the white outfit on top of the black outfit.
It's hard.
It's very hard.
Steps.
Yes.
And then just in a minute.
And now, a bit like 13, she's off to the Oscar, she doesn't get her Oscar.
But by the way, can I say that in Hannah, like, I literally wanted to learn how to fight after
really?
I saw that movie.
I'll teach you if you want.
Yes!
Girl on girl action!
That stage. So good.
God, I'm glad you liked
it. And you
it.
Carried that whole movie. It was like just you and so much of the movie.
Aw.
It's fantastic.
Thanks.
Yeah.
It's a bit of a love-in.
You sit beside me.
Because Taylor and Richard, you met at the Golden Globes.
We yeah. did. We actually sat next to each other.
Oh, how nice.
It was very nice.
Yeah.
She said, why are you here?
I have... It's just one of those times
said,
you just...
actually, I'm nominated. Oh, really? For what?
Best actor in a movie. Yeah, no, oh. That was... I really put my foot in my mouth on that one. And then, you know... But then I was absolutely freaked out because I met your wife, Carrie, who... And I said, it's so good to see you again. And she's like, in her head, I know she's going, never met this
never
girl before.
Met.
But it's because she was like my yeah. favorite assistant district attorney on Law & Order. And so I literally see her every week. She doesn't know it. Yeah. It was a good night for me. I was really on.
But when was your son there? Or was he just very happy to hear about you meeting Taylor?
Neither. What are you talking about? No, he wasn't there, but of course he was very impressed that I met her.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Of course
Nice.
Of course. Yeah.
You just people get around Richard Gere, they start making mistakes and like stuttering. They get
I know.
Nervous. It happened
no,
to you.
No, he makes
then.
You do it though. He makes you. He looks at you like, what are you talking about?
This is his such a tough guy.
Yeah. What are you talking about? Hey, thank you very much, Taylor, for coming to do that. It was fantastic. Just, oh, yeah, just lovely.
Nice. Thank
very,
you.
No,
very
seriously,
much.
We really, really appreciate it. But before we go tonight, well, let's have a visit to the big red chair. I know you're very
I'm
excited.
I'm so excited.
Okay, who's up first? Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Now, I've got to ask you, are you a Judi Dench fan?
Yeah.
Of course, of course.
No, is that seriously what that T-shirt means?
No.
What does it mean?
It's some, you know, the kids these days, the urban slang, Graham.
Okay. Does it mean anything?
It's vacuous. It doesn't mean anything.
I thought he'd sworn then, did you? What's your name, by the way?
Harris.
Harris?
Yes.
That's your first name?
That is my first name.
Okay.
I think I'm just going to do that.
Oh! Oh! Yes, you just wanted to do that.
It's like...
Is that all right?
No, it's like you're just channeling Hannah again.
It's true.
Yeah. She's just, like, in. She's like...
I feel like I've made it now. My life's complete now that I've done that.
But now, is Ethan Harris could have had the best story in the world?
But his name's Harris, though.
Says Saoirse. Yeah.
It's funny, though.
It's dear. Yeah. What's your middle name again? Tiffany. Who's up next? Who's up next? Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
What's your name?
Kelly.
Kelly. No, I think Kelly's going to tell a good
Kelly's
story.
Nice.
Yeah.
It's really
oh, yes.
She's lovely.
Everyone loves you so far.
Thank you.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. Nice homage, flash dance. We're liking it. Okay. Where do you live, Kelly?
I live in London, but I'm from South Africa.
Okay. And leave it. And. Okay, off you go, story.
Okay, so it was my first date, and I was really nervous, and the guy comes, and he was gorgeous. And he sits down. Cigarette, and I thought I was so cool, and I offered to light it for him.
Yes.
Don't know why, don't know what possessed me. And I light a cigarette, and he turns his face, and his hair suddenly, like, caught on fire. So I try to distract him, like, look, there's your mum, or whatever. And he looks, and I was trying to blow it out.
Oh, my God.
But then suddenly, he was wearing so much gel in his hair, it started to smell, and sparks were flying out of his head. And I literally, it was like in flames by this point, but he was so, I don't know, he just didn't realize, and I did what any normal person would do, I just ran.
You ran away! Can she walk?
Yeah!
You can walk, you can walk, Kelly. You can, yeah, walk, walk, there she goes, very good. You can just contact us via our website at this very address. Thank you so much to my guests tonight. Taylor Swift, everybody! John Malkovich! Saoirse Ronan! And Mr. Richard Gere! Join me next week with singer Olly Murs, star of Family Guy and Black Swan, Mila Kunis, Hollywood heartthrob Jude Law and James Franco, and the legendary Dame Judi Dench. I'll see you then. Good night, everyone. Bye-bye!
And more Richard Gere is never a bad thing. Next on BBC One, Pretty Woman.